Hi, I'm Nathan Oakley, and following on from my last video about trolls and trolling, I wanted to talk about one specific troll who got a few mentions in the last video, but maybe people hadn't read between the lines in terms of who I was actually talking about. That's perhaps a good thing. But in any event, the troll known as Tim Osman, with an S, has repositioned himself, and he's had to relinquish some of his trolling... what's the word? Trolling rights, let's just use that word. So some of the things that he could do as a faceless potato, he has stopped doing over the course of the build-up to him actually revealing his identity, his image. And that's quite an important thing. That's him. That is him in terms of what he is. So his image in terms of the ability that it gives him to become a real person online has changed the rules of engagement with Tim Osman, and people need to be aware of this. You know, it's a two-way street with a faceless potato, regardless of me having my identity out there. Again, some people picked up on this over the last few months when I've been trolling Tim Osman, but yeah, some didn't and took offence to me. But ultimately speaking, the rules of engagement have now changed. And they've been changed by him. So it's a smart move on his part by coming out and showing his face. It took me a couple of days to figure it out, I'm not going to lie. But now I realise why he has been repositioning himself up until now. And yeah, it's good, but he's the same bipolar troll he's always been, which is why my opinion hasn't changed of him. My respect level may have gone up for him one notch when he came out and revealed his identity in person and so on. But my respect has also gone up another notch when I figured out why he's done it and how he's positioned himself running up to that moment. It doesn't make him any less dangerous. And if anything, it possibly makes him more dangerous for some of the idiots that don't realise this has happened. And, you know, again, I give him kudos. He seems to employ a lot of psychopathic tactics. And, you know, the projection that he's currently doing and the hypocrisy that he's currently doing is going to trigger a lot of people into reacting. Some badly, and he has now got recourse. That's the bottom line. It's the same with anybody else. It's hard to explain when I have used myself as an example against him when he was anonymous by, you know, without going into too much graphic detail. I've subsequently apologised for this. Now he's revealed his identity in a comment, admittedly, and I'm not going to give him that much respect. But it's now in a situation where, unlike before, where me as a real person could pretty much say whatever I like to him, I can't now. That's the bottom line. People need to understand this. And me sighing because the penny has dropped for me isn't enough. So I'm going to put this out there right now that Tim Osman, the character known as Tim Osman, has changed the rules. He's no longer a character. You know, he's just got an alias, he's got a different name. The fact that he has got an AKA, Tim Osman, attached to that face doesn't change that face is a real person, and that real person could very much attack back should there be false accusations attached to that image, that person. You know, it doesn't matter that his name isn't real. The same applied to people like Orphan Red, Sasha, Orphan Blue, any of the other million names that she probably gives herself over the course of her online interactions. But that doesn't mean she doesn't have recourse. She absolutely does, just because she's not using her real name. People do that all the time to protect their identity. Patricia Steer did it when she was in radio. She gave herself a different name to protect her identity. Again, it didn't mean that she didn't have recourse if people started to stalk her. Yeah, but that's, you know, wasn't the case when Tim Osman was a completely faceless potato. You know, sticks and stones, you know, we want to make memes about me, you will expect me to abuse you. You know, but there's no recourse either way. So in other words, it's kind of inconsequential. But that's not the case anymore. So people just need to be aware of that. The other thing is, regardless of him positioning himself and me describing it as a chess game, the other reality is he is actually a real person. You know, he is just like I described on my previous video, a guy tapping away on a keyboard. And in the case of him meeting up with all the flat earthers, he was just that guy sat in the corner. That's all he was. You know, it saddens me to hear about people seeing that and then wanting to go up and physically abuse his equipment or him. I'm sure it was Jibby Jedi or I can't remember. I shouldn't have named names, but somebody from another chat has said, you know, if I'd have seen him tuppence I'd have gone over there. I think it was Pillbox. I will name and shame, unfortunately, Pillbox. But, you know, that's just a guy sat in the corner. The fact that until now he's done things on the internet as an anonymous troll doesn't mean that you can immediately go over and abuse him. For a start, you'd have probably a bit of a difficult time proving that was actually him that did any of those things. So even if he's taken credit for them along the lines, it's a bizarre situation to be in. So, you know, some people are going to have to press the reset button as far as Tim Osman is concerned, and that's unfortunate. Some people have to swallow their pride, especially when he does what he's doing already, which is throwing back in the face of the people like us that are labelled also as trolls with the things that he's done. You know, two wrongs don't make a right. And if people feel that just because he's gone around doxing people, displaying porn in their channels, that suddenly they can do that to him, they can't. That's the bottom line. Two wrongs don't make a right. And it's clever, I'm not going to lie. He's positioned himself very cleverly. I'm 99.9% certain it's intentional. And, you know, he's still here, and he's still going to be dangerous to people who don't realise this truth. The rules of engagement have changed. He has now revealed his identity. There's certain things that he's had to forego when doing that, or in reality on the run-up, which again is tactical. But unfortunately, the rules of engagement will change for us too, in terms of what we can and can't get away with when engaging with Tim Osman and others like him. I mean, he's now on that same level, as I said a moment ago, as someone like Sasha Orphan Red, who's out there with her name and face, just isn't her real name. But that doesn't mean that he's, you know, she's a faceless potato. She's not. You know, that's still a real person sat there, and now is same applies to Tim Osman. Good news, bad news, depending on how you view it and how you react to that guy now that he's done this. So, you know, at first everyone's jumping for joy. Oh, wow, we've caught this guy's face. In reality, when he was anonymous, I actually preferred it that way because I could get away with doing whatever I liked to him with absolutely no recourse whatsoever from him. I mean, that being said, I've given that up on the run-up watching him change his ways, not because I knew that he would come out and give himself some form of recourse by putting his identity out there in the form of his image. So it's an interesting one. Just want people to be aware of this situation and not necessarily go around doing as you have had done to you by this particular troll, this particular individual, this particular person. You know, you can't go around accusing people of showing child porn if it's just simply not the case. And he is taking credit when he was anonymous for some of these things that have happened. And again, that's just positioning. You know, now he's playing the martyr and saying, oh no, poor me, these people are attacking me and, you know, you can't use my face. And he's doing this because presumably, this is my interpretation, this may or may not be true, I'm sure it'll correct me in the comments if I'm wrong, but he's hoping for that fire to come at him, because in this instance, there's a psychopathic mirror he can hold straight back up to it as that person, as that image, as that online face that is literally him. So, you know, you've got to be conscious that if you start pointing a gun at him, he's going to turn those bullets straight back at you. So there we go. I'll leave it to that. I've been Nathan Oakley. I'll see you in the next video.